Let's get into it now. Qantas has been all over the headlines this week with CEO Alan Joyce announcing he's stepping down from his role 2 months early. This actually marks the first time Qantas has had an early departure. Many people are angry at the $24 million golden parachute Alan Joyce is set to pocket after his tenure at Australia's most complained about company, but we have it on good authority the $24 million we paid out in Qantas flight credits. So they're actually worth $10 million and expire in November. Mr. Joyce has vacated his office, but in the spirit of Qantas, instead of being sent to his mansion in Sydney, his belongings will be shipped to Albania, it says there. And speaking of departures, this week we also said goodbye to Reserve Bank Governor Philip Lowe, who is leaving his post after 7 years. Lowe, we remembered as the man who gave us 12 recent interest rate hikes. He gave his last scintillating public speech in the role this week, which ironically yielded record low interest. And look, some people say he was unfairly maligned towards the end of his career. I just hope he finds a little more public adoration in his new career as a parking inspector. And now to someone we wish would go away. It appears Prince Andrew is back. After he was snapped with Kate and Will driving to a church together on a recent trip to Scotland. The royal family say his work, correspondence, travel arrangements and other activities will remain secret until 2065, which does seem like a long time to keep things under wraps, but the palace is hoping by then Epstein's Isle will be swallowed by the rising seas. To sport now, and the AFL have revealed that the ageing rock and rollers Kiss, who are now in their 70s, will be playing the September 30 grand final for the very first time. However, they're not going to rock and roll all night. They've got to be done by 5 p.m. so they can make the early bird special the RSL. The AFL apparently wanted Kylie Minogue, but she said, oh, no, thank you, I'm still culturally relevant. This week, we also got a glimpse at Network 10's The Amazing Race Australia. Dramatic footage, gold Logie winner Grant Denyer is seen collapsing in what appears to be quite a serious medical episode. The producers have surveyed 100 people to come up with the top 10 ways to help, Grant. Survey says, call an ambulance! And finally to Hollywood, 89-year-old Al Pacino announced he is separated from his 29-year-old partner, Noor Al-Fallah. Pacino's first big break came in the 1972 film The Godfather. And actually, Al-Fallah couldn't watch the film back then because she wasn't born, and this is true, her mother was 7 years old. Pacino and Al-Fallah welcomed a baby together just 3 months ago. Noor had complained that with both Al and the newborn, there were just too many nappies to change. Thank you, everyone. That was...